throughout history, only Israel has protected the freedom of all peoples and faiths in Jerusalem.
Today, the air is all static, so the amplifier is static. The music is loud, the air is loud, and, you know, we're trying to settle things down a little bit.
Two, one, two, three, four.
Has expressed fears of a full-scale war as the deadly conflict between Israeli forces and Palestinians continues for a third day. Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu warned Palestinian militants that this was just the beginning, threatening to strike with blows they haven't dreamed of.
Our pilgrimage through the Holy Land begins at Haifa, a picturesque port on the Mediterranean. Here we land to journey forth to holy places whose names are revered throughout the world. We gaze down at Haifa from Mount Carmel, the traditional site of Elijah's sacrifice. Off the beaten road of travel, the ancient town of Nazareth lies secluded on the slopes of Galilee. It has changed but little since he who is called the Nazarene dwelt here in his childhood.
this morning when you knocked upon my door. Early this morning, ooh, when you knocked upon my door. Me and the devil was walking side by side. Me and the devil, ooh, was walking side by side. Beat my woman until I get satisfied. She said, you don't see why that I will dog around. My baby, you know you ain't doing me right now. She said, you don't see why, ooh, that I will dog around. It must be that only the spirit so deep down in the ground. You may bear my body by the highway side. Baby, I don't care where you bear my body when I'm dead and gone. You may bear my body, ooh, down by the highway side.
Thank you. This is a photo of me in my first year of school. There are about 38 children in this class, and of whom 6 survived.
They took my father, and I remember I was on the street with my mom when they took him because they cut his beard off, they made fun of him. And my mother started crying, and she said, you know what, I bet you I'm not going to see you again. And my father said, no, God will be there, don't worry. And because she cried, I cried with her. I was very close to my mom. So that's the last time I saw my father. Although they told me they're going to take him to the Russian front and they're going to dig trenches. And I told myself, well, it's only 1 year. He was only 34 years old. It's nothing wrong to work. That's what I thought. So I didn't take any notice. But after the war, I found out my father never went to Russia. They took him straight to Auschwitz in the gas chamber.
Hey, mama said the way you move gonna make you sweat, gonna make you groove.
Strong points are taken after being blasted to rubble. During the mopping up operations, Haganah forces seek out every Arab, and barricades are set up to screen those who had not already fled the city. Everyone is searched. With the relinquishing of the British mandate, Palestine is rocked by full-scale war, and both sides mobilize. Arab captives are held for evacuation to Acre. Women flee with what belongings they can carry. And as Palestine struggles for national existence, the United Nations wrestles with the problem. Here, Sir Alexander Cadogan states Britain's unchanging stand on the mandate. Palestine's case is before the World Parliament as Arab delegates look on stonily. In a tense atmosphere, the Assembly hears a statement of momentous importance read by United States delegate.
The United States recognizes the provisional government as the de facto authority of the new state of Israel.
I am just a poor boy, though my story is seldom told. I have squandered my resistance for a pocket full of mumbles, such are promises. All lies and chest, still the man hears what he wants to hear and disregards the rest. When I left my home and my family, was no more than a boy in the company of strangers, in the quiet of the railway station, red and scared, laying low, seeking out the poor quarters where the ragged people go, looking for the places only they would know. Lie-la-lie, asking only workmen's wages, I come looking for a job, but I get no offers, just to come home from the wars on 7th Avenue. I do declare there were times when I was so lonesome I took some comfort there. La, 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 la.
Mr. President of the United States, Mr. President of the Arab Republic of Egypt, ladies and gentlemen, the Camp David Conference should be renamed. It was the Jimmy Carter Conference. The President undertook an initiative most imaginative in our time and brought President Sadat and myself and our colleagues and friends and advisors together under one roof. In itself, it was a great achievement, but the President took a great risk for himself and did it with great civil courage. And it was a famous French field commander who said that it is much more difficult to show civil courage than military courage. And the president worked. As far as my historic experience is concerned, I think that he worked harder than our forefathers did in Egypt building the pyramids. Yes, indeed, he worked day and night, and so did we.
Amen.
Day and night. We used to go to bed at Camp David between 3 and 4 o'clock in the morning, rise as we are used to since our boyhood, between 5 and 6, and continue working. The president showed interest in every section, every paragraph, every sentence, every word, every letter of the framework agreement. We had some difficult moments. As usually, there are some crises in negotiations. As usually, somebody gives a hint that perhaps he would like to pack up and go home. It's all usual. But ultimately, ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States won the day. And peace now celebrates a great victory for the nations of Egypt and Israel and for all mankind. Mr. President, we the Israelis thank you from the bottom of our hearts for all you have done for the sake of peace, for which we pray and yearn more than 30 years. The Jewish people suffered much, too much, and therefore peace to us is a striving coming innermost from our heart and soul. Now, when I came here to the Camp David conference, I said, perhaps as a result of our work, one day people will in every corner of the world be able to say, Habemus Pacem, in the spirit of these days. Can we say so tonight? Not yet. We still have to go a road until my friend President Sadat and I sign the peace treaties. We promised each other that we shall do so within 3 months. Mr. President, tonight, at this celebration of a great historic event, let us promise each other that we shall do it earlier than between 3 months.
Just a perfect day. Drink sangria in the park. And then later, when it gets dark, we go home. Just a perfect day. Feed animals in the zoo. Then later, a movie too, and then home. Oh, it's such a perfect day. I'm glad I spent it with you.
Palestinians, they have to stop all this nonsense of the riots, of throwing stones, of wounding people. It's useless.
Israelis are killing us and shooting and beating us all the time. So we think any one of us could do this. Anyone from 6 to 50 might carry out this act.
The mayor hides the crime rates, councilwoman hesitates, public gets irate, but forgets the vote dates. Weatherman complaining, predicted sun, it's raining. Everyone's protesting, boyfriend keeps suggesting, you're not like all of the rest. garbage ain't collected, women ain't protected, politicians using, people they're abusing, the mafia's getting bigger, like pollution in the river, and you tell me that this is where it's at. Woke out this morning with an ache in my head. I splashed on my clothes as I spilled out of bed. I opened the window to listen to the news, but all I heard was the establishment's blues. Gun sales are soaring, housewives find life boring, divorce the only answer, smoking causes cancer, the system's gonna fall soon to an angry young tune, and that's a concrete co-fact. The Pope digs population, freedom from taxation, teeny bops are uptight, drinking at a stoplight, miniskirt is flirting, I can't stop so I'm hurting, Spencer sells her hopeless chest, adultery plays the kitchen, bigot cops than fiction, the little man gets shafted, sons and money's drafted, living by a timepiece, new war in the Far East, can you pass the Rorschach test? It's a hassle, it's an educated guess. Well, frankly, I couldn't care less.
Lacoste and cheaper brands, Cadillac, Amtrak, gasoline, diesel,
a standard of living. Could this be the reason
that we would choose to kill a child?
Jehovah, Buddha, Christ, Confucius, Collier, red beans and rice, goujons of soul, read a full ham hock, locks, bagels and bones, and commandments in stone. Bible, Quran, Shinto, Islam, prosciutto, risotto, falafel and ham. There's a dogma, donuts, ridicule, faith, fear of the dog, shame, disgrace.
That we would choose to kill the child. Choose to kill the child.
It's cold in the desert, space is too big, rope is too short and the walls are too thick. I will show you no weakness, I will mock you in song, berate and beride you, belittle and chide you, beat you with sticks and bulldoze your home. You can watch my triumphal procession to Rome. Best seat in the house, up there on the cross. Is it anger or envy, or profit or loss?
That we would choose to kill the child.
Thank you.
can run. You don't have to be someone. I went on a summer cruise on an ocean bound to lose. My brother said that he was dead. I saw his face and shook my head. Can you see where we can be? We're losing our blood in the sea. Jazz is the starvation. That's only our salvation. Yes, it's the starvation. That's only our salvation.
שעוד בכל חלקי גופו, הוא הגיע שהוא במצב הכרה תקין, במקביל עקב חבלת פנים מאוד קשה וסכנה לדרכי האוויר שלו, הוא יורד לחדר ניתוח להמשך צפייה.
ירושלים, הוא לא ניכנע לתכתיבים שלכם, לא לאיומים שלכם. מאוד מצער שחבר בממשלת ישראל מנסור אבס מדבר על התגרות, על צעדה בירושלים עם דגל זה התגרות. זה הפרצוף של הממשלה הזאת, כך נראית הממשלה הזאת. אבל אנחנו על הפעם וחלחמתם, אנחנו צועדים בירושלים.
אלפי דגלים! Thank you.
you drive away?
No, you can't. Not unless you get in front of the car as I step on it. I'm only teasing. Okay, here we go. Ready?
See it, sir.
Ready?
If I were alone, I would cry. And if I were with you, I'd be home and dry. And if I go insane, will you still let me join in with the game?
With you more often.